श्रुति श्रीति पुराणादि पंचरात्रिं विधि विना वैकांतिक हरेर भक्ति उत्पतोव कल्पते। श्रुति श्रुति पुराणादि पंचरात्रिं विधि विना वैकांतिक हरेर भक्ति उत्पतोव कल्पते। गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर हेविली स्पीकिंग टू ए सो कॉल्ड डिवोटी दैट यू आर गोइंग टू लीव द वे ऑफ प्रणिपात एंड परिप्रश्न। यू आर गोइंग टू लीव द पाथ ऑफ परिपात एंड परिप्रश्न। यू आर गोइंग टू लीव श्रौत पंथा। यू आर गोइंग टू फॉलो your fanciful mind as your master. You are following to your fanciful mind. Actually, Mayadevi, you are going to follow the track of Maya, not actually devotional line. You are going to take rest from spiritual line. I mean, Sauta Pantha. So we have nothing to do for you. Actually, in Gita, we find one sloka by Sri Krishna, how to get divine knowledge. Divine knowledge is not a matter of joke. How you can get divine knowledge? It is given in Gita, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Arjuna. पनिपातेनो परिप्रश्नेनो सेवया उपदेक्षन्ति ते ज्ञानं ज्ञानिनस्तत्त्वदर्शिनः। प्रणिपात परिप्रश्न सेवा इज द वे थ्रू विच वी कैन अप्रोच ए स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर तत्वज्ञानी पुरुष हु कैन गिव अस नॉलेज थ्रू सेवा। If we are going to serve a Tathacharya in our perceptual channel, then surely you are going to get exact Tathagyan. Yesterday I was speaking about one sloka from Padma Puran, that without out of these four sampradaya, sampradaya vihina je mantraha asti nishphala mataha, any mantra you are going to get out of these four sampradayas, you are going to get mantra from any out of these four sampradayas, that mantra is not authentic. Somebody can fight, why not? Actually, point is that if Ganga coming out from Gangotri, following certain tracks through which Ganga coming to us in Navadvip, if we like to collect Ganga water, we cannot go to a separate river than Ajayanadi. We can say, well, I am getting Ganga, not possible. Ganga coming from Gangotri and certain tracks following. So if you want to get Ganga water, you will have to go there and collect Ganga water. Then and only then you can say that you are collecting Ganga water without not. Similarly, through some perceptual channels, through four sampradayas, different main acharyas are there. I already told you, Brahma Madhya Sampradaya, Brahma, Ramanuja Sampradaya, Sri Lakshmi Devi, Nimbarka Sampradaya, Chatushan, Vishnu Swami Sampradaya, Rudra. This way, those are the main acharya through which through perceptual channel, we are going to get the power of that mantra. Of course, at all, we are going to accept an authentic guru. If there is a breakage of Guru Parampara in between, you cannot realize, you think he is a Guru of the... This is not the calculation. This is not the calculation. This way you cannot calculate that he is in the line. Actually, Baladev Buddha Bhushan, Siddhanta Ratna, or some other book I already told, na? Prameya Ratnavali, there you can go very minutely, you can find the mood of Baladev Buddha Bhushan, the Tathacharya. He wanted to speak that if there is breakage in Guru Parampara, in that case surely you are not going to get the same power as you are expecting. Follow. So if there is a breakage, I mean Parampara going, there is one breakage in Guru Parampara, maybe there is some fall down. Any mantra we are going to get from one Paramahansa Acharya, any authentic Acharya, be sure he is Siddha Mahatma. In mantra he is Siddha. The mantra he is going to get from his Gurudev, he is taking his life, he is doing sadhana. For sadhana Siddha, anitya Siddha, always Siddha, no problem. So their mantra is always full of birja, birja means power. Their mantra is full of birja, I mean full of power. So, if you are going to get that mantra, also if you are going to practice that mantra in authentic way, following the instructions of your Guruji, following in toto, in that case also you can develop that kind of power. The example given in Chaitanya Charitamrita is that Srila Madhavendra Puripada is the main pillar of Gaudiya Sampradaya, it is spoken. Okay, because from Madhavendra Puripada, this kind of prema falling. How? I already give answer. Inside the heart of Madhavendra Puripada, by the desire of Krishna, some secrets are there. That Gauranga Mahaprabhu appear inside his heart already. So it was possible for Madhavendra Puripada to show this kind of exclusive prema. Very nice prema. Impossible. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asking, Without the link of Madhavendra Puripada, how you have any link with Madhavendra Puripada? When Sanariya Brahman in Mathura there, Adi Keshav, Mahaprabhu gone there dancing, he watching the prema of that. Then they asking, how is possible? You have any link? Well, yes, I have a link. Srila Puripada came here and he took prasadam in my room and bestow kipa on me. And from them I am enjoying this kind of, you know, exclusive feeling. Oh, really? I can also take prasadam for you? No. How you can take prasadam? Actually, I am Sonoriya Brahman, fallen soul. Actually, people, they are in the society, they can criticize if you come to my house and take prasadam is not a rule here in our society. What rule you mean? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, what rule you mean? Mahayano yeno gato sapanta. Srila Madhavendra Puripada, the great, he took prasadam at your home, so who am I to pass any kind of judgment and calculate? No, I am going to take prasadam in your house, really so. This way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to prove, if you find any disparity in Guru, apparently, they are very powerful, but apparently if you some disparity, but still, Mahaprabhu speaking, you need not play your head over that, what he is doing. Because if you want to pass any judgment, if you want to find any fault with him, you are going to fall down. So it is a rule what Gurudev, Paramahansa Gurudev doing, that is the rules. So actually there is a rule. So this way we learn from Sriman Mahaprabhu that authentic Guru Parampara should be followed, and if there is any breakage, Baladev Vidyavasan thinking, in that case big problem. Guru Niravakara, Guru Parampara, we need, you know, exact flow of prema. There we find in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Srila Ishwar Puripad serving Madhavendra Puripad from heart. Srila Madhavendra Puripad, he is serving Madhavendra Puripad from heart. From heart, exactly in toto. That's why it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Ishwar Puripad going to get the full treasure that was there inside the heart of Madhavendra Puripad. So is why not possible at present? Also possible. We are not going to take the treasure there inside the heart of Prabhupada, no? Why? Why not? If I am sincere, that kind of tattva-gyan can flourish, get manifest inside my heart by the mercy of Prabhupada, what not possible? I can give the example of Kuresh, how it was possible for Kuresh to develop this kind of vast knowledge. Kuresh is actually Ramangsa. Ramanujaja Lakshman himself, Ram Anuja, and Kuresh is Lakshmanangsa. Follow this way, we find that exactly possible. Why not possible? We should not put any kind of argument. So Pranipat, Paripashno, Seva. Those three factors we should have in our life fulfilled. Then we can get Tattva-gyan from Tattvacharya. Not that is not having any Tattva-gyan you are going to follow. That's why I started with the sloka that Suti Siti Puranadi Pancharatting Vidhing Vina. Vaikantika Harer Bhakti Utpata Iva Kalpate. We have to follow our Guru Varga in toto, exactly what Prabhupada Bhakti Mata Thakur. If you want to make some, you know, calculation and make some rules and regulations separately, then Prabhupada speaking, slightest deviation from the track of your Guru Path Padma can ultimately throw you away from your bhajan track. Slightest deviation, because today's slightest deviation, maybe tomorrow this deviation can get a bifurcate and make a huge gapping. In that case, you can get isolated from the lotus feet of Guru Padma, like Ramchandra Puri. Ramchandra Puri wanted to find fault with Guru Padma. Ramchandra Puri wanted to advise to Guru Padma. So much audacity, he wanted to give advice to Guru. Oh, you are kind, you are Brahma. Then Guru Padma would throw him out. Throw him out, go, foolish. I am not going to get the lotus feet of Krishna, I am crying all their separation. He is idiot coming to advise me about Brahma. Go, anywhere, you get lost. Don't try to show your face. If I see your face, then I am not going to get divine, you know, gati. I cannot get, go. From then, Madhav Srila Ramchandra Puripad developed this kind of aparad, and gradually that aparad going to touch the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When you are going to make aparad unto the lotus feet of pure Vaishnava, you are not going to pay attention, you are not going to ignore, oh, no aparad. Then that aparad can go on and going to give you inspiration to do more and more aparad, and then you can fall down. Better if you feel you have done some aparad, then why not you go and make the road clear? Okay, Maharaj, I have done, Mr. What to do, I am bonded soul. Please excuse me. Then Guru Vaishnava merciful can excuse you, you can start your bhajan freshly. But if you are going to put argument, that big problem. So it is written, Shruti Shruti Puranadi, Shruti Shruti Puranadi Pancharatri Vidhing Vina. Without the instructions in Pancharatra, Puran, authentic Puran, Shati, and they are in Vedanta means Sautapanta. Because you know the other name of breath is Shruti, so Sautapanta. So the exact knowledge of Vedanta we can expect from authentic Acharya and perceptual channel. not separately. Anywhere I can go and get, not possible. So this way, it is written there in Rasamrita Sindhu also, and also you can find Gauriya Kanta Har, a special point, Suti Siti Puranadi Pancharatik, meaning Biding Vina, Vaikantika Harer Bhakti Utpata Ivo Kalpata. Utpat means all big disturbance in the way of this bhajan track. Yesterday I was speaking, Samigyo Srausam Pantaha Santapa Varjita. Samigyo Srausam Pantaha Santapa Varjita Anavapto Sramam Jeno Santop Pratasthire. Anavapto Sramam Jena Santo Patasthire. I mean, our previous acharya, those who are going to follow the track, if you are going to follow the track without any calculation, without, you know, any argument, is very easy for you. You need not play your head. You go on following, then you can come out successful. So, Samigyo, it is written, Samigyo. You will have to find out the exact track. Already our Guru Varga following, that track you will have to place yourself on the same track. If the train is derailed, then you cannot come out successful. So, Samigyo Srausam Pantaha Santapa Varjita. Santapa means you are not going to get any punishment, any, you know, problem, nothing. Anabhapta Samam Purvam Santaha Yeno Pratasthire. Previous acharyas, they following that, you have to follow same. No problem, no headache, nothing. So it was advised yesterday. Now, today is the Tirubhav Tithi of the great Ramanujacharya. All four acharyas, they took birth in South India. So in Bhagavad Mahima, it is written, Bhakti Devi speaking, I grew up in South India, and then this way when I go to Gujarat, Gujardesh, then my body become collapse. Because no bhakti there. It is in Bhakti Devi giving identify. Follow in Bhagavad Mahima. Very nice. So actually those four acharya, turning acharyas, they all took birth in South India. We are very lucky to speak it. So yesterday I was speaking about Madhvacharya Vasudev, whose childhood name was Vasudev. And today actually is the Tirubhav Tithi of Srila Ramanujacharya the Great. Actually, Mahabhutpuri, I am not going to discuss about details. I am going to touch some points. After that I am going to discuss Siddhanta. And yesterday, tomorrow also I can discuss some points to clarify. So Ramanujacharya actually is from Madras, certain distance actually, Mahabhutpuri, Mahabhutpuram. Mahabhutpuri is the Abhirbhav place of Ramanujacharya, Kesavacharya. Kesavacharya is the Gurudev. Kesavacharya is Gurudev. Hey, Gurudev, father. Father is also Gurudev. Father, mother, they are also primary Gurudev. So, actually, Kesavacharya, Kantimoti, mother. Mother Kantimoti and father Kesavacharya. They are from a very, very high class traditional family tradition. Very nice, high class Brahmin family. So, Ramanujacharya actually took birth. And actually, Kesavacharya and Kantimati praying in front of Bharadaraj, oh Prabhu, we have no such, you know, children, nothing. After that, taking some bow, after that, the boy took birth. And I can discuss Abhirbhav Tithi, or not him. But when Shailapurna, the maternal uncle, I mean the elder brother of Kantimati, maternal uncle of Ramanujacharya, Lakshman, how they put name Lakshan? Shailapurna is a disciple of whom? Shailapurna is a disciple of Jamunacharya. Very nice. And big devotion with him, always, every time. So Shailapurna got information that my sister, she is going to give birth to a very nice baby. So he came to take darshan, and whenever watching the boy, he is finding some nice symptom in hands and legs and body, just like Ramanuja, Lakshman. So he was bound to keep the name. His name should be Lakshman, Lakshman Deshi, Lakshman. From then everybody is speaking is Lakshman, okay. But after that, he is growing up, and from childhood, he is growing exclusive medha, brain, exclusive power, memory power. Going on learning all, you know, Vakaran, everything, Ved, Veda, everything. He took decision to go to where that place named Madurai, near Madurai, one place. So he wanted to took decision to go there to learn Vedanta from one big Acharya that time. They are speaking that way. We are not going to pass that kind of remark. He is actually Vedanta Acharya, but Mayavadi Vedanta Acharya. But actually, anyway, Ramanacharya, when growing up, father and mother, Kantimuti mother and father who? Kesavacharya. They took decision, because when growing up, the boy, getting education also exclusive, then when they thought it necessary to arrange marriage. But one thing very important, from very childhood, the boy showing extreme love and respect for Guru Vaishnava. That is a special thing. From very childhood, he is going to express love and respect for Guru Vaishnava. Who teach him? Who knows? But father, mother, they are watching that boy is very nice and always paying respect, not only to Bharadraj, to Guru Vaishnava all the time. Yeah. So, whenever Kanchipurno, one nice devotee, Kanchipurno is nice, he is also the disciple of Jamunacharya, Kanchipurno. He used to come from his village and going through that path, I mean the house of Ramanacharya, Lakshman Deshik, every day. He is coming from his village and going through the track path there and going to Bharadraj daily to take darshan of Bharadraj. And worshipping daily, going to worship Bharadraj and doing bhajan there every day, going while Lakshman Deshik standing in gate watching that Vaishnava. He could easily realize that he is very nice Vaishnava. So he used to pay dandavada every day. One day, without the permission of father mother, Lakshman Deshik inviting that devotee Kanchipurno to take prasadam in home. Father, mother was stunned. The small boy calling, you must take prasadam in our house. Okay, I can come back from Bharadraj and take prasadam in your house and go. But after serving himself, that boy growing up, he is serving himself. Mother cooking, is serving himself. After prasadam is over, he wanted to arrange some rest for that great devotee, and wanted to massage the lotus feet of that Kanchipurna. Kanchipurna was very ashamed. Why you are going to take trouble this way? No. I am from very low family. I am from very, very low caste, Shudra. You should know that. No, I cannot tell. You are from high family, you see. Then Lakshman Desik with very, full of tears speaking, this was the first time I hear from you. The Vaishnava is Shudra. Vaishnava is never Shudra. Vaishnava is always more than Brahman. Vaishnava is the teacher of Brahman. Why you speak this way? Huh? Tiruppan Allah. Tiruppan, say Alwar. He was actually from Chandal. Chandal, you know? Chandal, you don't know? Chandal? Ah. It's a Chandal family. Tiruppan Allah. Why you speak this way? Tiruppan Alwar was a great devotee. Why you speaking this way? We already know Shatokop, the case of Shatokop. Or in this line, we know everything, the how they, you know, everybody going to, you know, dishonor them, how Krishna arranged, Narayan arranged, that they are my great devotee. How you, Munibahan, Shatokop, Munibahan, all the same. Munibahan, I mean, the Supreme Lord was very angry. When that Brahman Pujari going to take the water from river, and he find the Shudra is lying, hey! He take one stone and throw on him. Hey! Get up! Then the Supreme Lord become very angry. When he come back to Ho temple, the temple is, door is closed automatically. I am not going to take any orsi from you. What punishment? You will have to carry that Vaishnava on your shoulder and travel, you know, many times, 8 times, or I forget. You have to travel, do parikram. Then from there, his name was Munibahan. So this way, Supreme Lord always going to put rules and regulation perfectly to show that Vaishnava is above all. You cannot compare any Vaishnava with any Brahman, any Karmakandi Purush, nobody. You cannot compare. So, you can remember, I already told many times, that Banhi Suryo Vaishnavibhyo, Banhi Suryo Brahmanibhyo Tayyana Vaishnava Ushada. Banhi means fire. Don't put up your hand inside fire. You can burn up your... Banhi Suryo Brahmanibhyo Vaishnavo Tejyan Sada. Banhi, fire is dangerous. Don't put hand. Suryo, sunlight, if you ingest a... And Vaisa, if you go, you can grow, you can develop sunstroke and die. Many people dying in dry regions there. In Rajasthan, those who are not having any idea about how to save from the scorchy sunlight, they are dying. In hospital, they are taken there, dead. Follow what I say. This way, with sun, no compromise. Big problem. And Brahman... Okay, Brahman is powerful, a pure Brahman. Pure Brahman automatically means having some Shraddha, respect from Vishnu. If Brahman not going to pay any respect to Vishnu, what kind of Brahman is? Eh? Brahman, the name coming from which point? Brahmachari, where from you? Brahmachari, chari mean charan. Brahme vicharati iti brahmachari. Hey. Brahman also. Brahmani ramate iti brahman. Not impersonal Brahma. Follow. Then the Mayavadi it can become no Vaishnava. So automatically all the meaning, if we going to find out the exact meaning, we can find Brahman mean. Automatically, he should have, he must have devotion, I mean bhakti, unto the lotus feet of Krishna. It's a must. So this way, you see, he is going to give nice argument in with folded hand in front of Kanchipurna. How you say like this? We heard that Brahman, Vaishnava is the guru of all Brahman. So in your line, you know, lineage already we find, you see, Actually, Shatoko, all, everybody. Tiruppanalla, they are great Vaishnava. They are great Acharya. How you speak this? Okay. Then Kanchipurna was very happy. He blessed from inside that you develop bhakti. Then Acharya gradually going on, growing aspiration to gather knowledge, I mean bhakti, everything. In the meantime, when the only son growing up gradually, they took decision to arrange marriage. They took decision to arrange marriage for the boy. So naturally, I was bound to marry. No desire to marriage. No desire to marriage, but what to do? Father and mother requesting, you will have to marry. So you are bound to get marry. But marriage is marriage, nothing else. Marriage. As the meaning of marriage is marriage. I explain this way. Really so. So marriage. Okay. But after that, but the wife was from a very karmakandi tradition. Very always, you know. Not that, always speaking like this. So developing that kind of mood. Actually, after that, he was bound to take decision to go to that Vedanta Acharya, Jadava Acharya, to take some lesson on Vedanta. Okay, we heard this prominent Acharya there, let him. But when going to there, Kanchipuram, I'm meeting at that place. Actually learning Vedanta from that Vedanta Acharya, Jadava Acharya, with seva. I told, without seva, never in your life you can develop tattva gyan. Never. You can try your best. No. In guru tradition you can follow. You need not fight with people. If you find that in this guru parampara, that sadhu developing that kind of profound knowledge by the mercy of guru, that I find an exclusive, then you must understand he has direct linkage. You need not fight with people. Maybe somebody are acting as acharya. He is devoid of any knowledge. Maybe material knowledge. Even if I already started with the sloka that Suti Siti Purana Adi Pancharatting Biding Bina Vaikantika Harer Bhakti Utpata Ivakalpate. I already told explanation. So this way he started serving Jadava Acharya, messaging leg, everything. Messaging while on whole body before bath, arranging bath, everything doing. Well, one day he was messaging while, and one, so-called student coming to put one question before Jadava Acharya. Kapyasan, I would like to get the exact meaning of this. Then actually Jadava Acharya, Ramanujaja, Lakshman Desik messaging and that Jadava Acharya speaking. Kopi, monkey, his backside, the lower portion is red, Kapyasan, this meaning the lotus and eyes of Prabhu is just red like the backside of a monkey. When he got this kind of definition, he heard, he started crying, and the hot water from the tears rolling down on his cheeks and falling on the backside of Acharya. He was soaked. Why? What? You crying? Why? Actually, you are speaking this way, that's why I'm crying. You crying? This is the meaning given by Shankaracharya. You going to find fault with Shankar, the previous Acharya? How dare you? You have your power? You explain. Then you are bound to explain very nicely. Kapyasam kang, kang mean water, pibati. Sun, giving sunlight, and water is sucking water. Follow. So this way is explaining, and us, this dhatu was a root, I mean root, dhatu, was explained for, you know, vikash. Vikash mean expansion. Is the just like one lotus flower by sunlight expressing its full in full blossom, just like that when, you know, sun rises and Kong Pivoti, that's why it is sun. You can compare us this way. Then you are shocked. Oh my God, this small boy explaining this way from Chandogya Upanishad, this sloka is very nice. Kang jalam pibati iti kapihi suryaha evang asdhatu. I already mentioned. Tasso yataka pyasan pundarika meva kshini. This sloka from Chandogya Upanishad. Follow this sloka. So this way Acharya was soaked. Another day, when another sloka he was explaining, that sloka is from Uttaittariya Upanishad. Satyam Jnanam Anantam, this. Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. That time also, he is going to break the Siddhanta of Acharya and going to establish Bhakti Siddhanta. At that time he was very shocked. No, he is going to become a great enemy of our sampradaya. I think he is going to eradicate the structure of Sankara Sampradaya. Be careful. Then he took decision to kill that boy. No other way. He is going to become a big Acharya, Vaishnava Acharya, to eradicate that Sankara philosophy, Sankara Darshan. Big danger. Then he took decision to kill that boy, but not directly, indirect way. Wow. Oh my boy, we like to take bath in, you know, Triveni Sangam, that confluence of three river. Confluence of three river, Ganga, Jumuna, Saraswati in Triveni Sangam, Allahabad. So we like to take you with, yes, I can go. Then they took decision to go together, they get together and started moving towards Allahabad, Triveni Sangam. In the way, it's quite natural that Kanchipuram, long distance from there, Mahabhutpuri, almost there then, near Madras. So long day they are going together. One, you know, actually, one, you know, relative, his name was Govinda. He was there in this group. He was also the, you know, student of that foolish teacher. He was also falling. In the middle, when they are entering into the deep forest, it was the decision of that Acharya to allow Ramanujacharya alone and let tiger or, you know, lion can eat up this boy. This was the target. We are not going to kill with knife, nothing. Not going to apply any poison. Oh, we can speak what to do. We all moving towards that. In the meantime, he was isolated from our group and somehow he was attracted by tiger. In between, very quickly, Govinda was a little bit isolated and he informed to Ramanujacharya, Ramanu, Lakshman, they took decision to kill you. Really? Yes. You fly from here. Then, actually, Lakshman Desik running like mad. Without any direction, without knowing any direction where to go. North, east, west, south, no knowledge. Running. By the desire of Bharadwaj, running. He was just tired. And he was thinking where to go, how to go back to Kanchipuram. In between, he watching that one Veda, you know, hunter, husband and wife. Hunter and wife, one hunter and his wife, both of them falling. Oh, where you are going? Actually, I'm going. Oh, I can also go with you because I have no knowledge about that way. Okay, you can go. In the meantime, when sun set, there was darkness coming, they were bound to take shelter of a big tree. Somehow in certain portion of the tree. But the wife of that, you know, hunter, she was very thirsty. She wanted to drink water. Lakshman said, well, I can arrange water. The hunter said, not now. Now darkness. Morning time you can give. Okay. When sun again rise in the east, then it was the first duty of Lakshman Desik to arrange water from a certain, from a nice source. He go and search, and there is no pot where to, how to bring water. Ramanujacharya was very healthy. He took water in handful. Three handfuls of water brought, giving to the wife of that hunter. Fourth time, when gone to take fourth time the water, then the fine, where gone they? Hunter and wife vanish. But at the same time, Lakshman Das discover, where is the shouting everywhere? Shouting everywhere, so much, so many people were, they took a, what place this is? This is Kanchipuram. Kanchipuram? How possible? I was thousands of miles away from Kanchipuram. Oh, how possible? He prayed on the way to Bharadraji and praying, you know, crying, and then speak all the story in front of Kanchipuram. Kanchipuram saying it was the arrangement of Shaksha, direct Lakshmi Narayan, took the form of hunter and his wife, Bo. The Lakshmi Devi took direct seva from you. You are so lucky, you are so lucky, I cannot speak all about your luck. In the meantime, when that idiot, Acharya Yadavacharya took information, well, Lakshman, we don't see Lakshman. The Govinda very tricky. Govinda saying, we don't find Lakshman where? Oh, well, inside very happy. Maybe tiger and, lion or, wolf. Can't eat up. Very nice. Oh, we are missing his, acting. He's acting in a very, kapat. Oh, we are missing. Oh, Lakshman, you are so nice student in my... But inside very happy. Gone. That problem gone from my life. After that, when they took decision to come back to Kanchipuram, they discover Lakshman Desik is there. There. Oh, you here? And started crying, oh, my student, dear student, I'm very happy to see. Inside say, oh, I couldn't kill him. Follow this way. Kapat. After that, again, you must come and your course is not yet complete. You must come and take. Okay. Ramanujacharya also externally going to give honor. Okay. Acharya, I must come to take. Follow. Because Prabhupada also teaches us this way. Externally, you will have to show respect to those material people. Otherwise, you can put garbage in your bhajan line. Let them take honor and go away. Money, position and honor. We are going to do bhajan undisturbed way. It's a trick. Prabhupada teaches us. We will have to give full honor. Okay, very good. Ah, come. But inside we are not going to take any association of that man, Prabhupada speaking. Internally, don't try to take association of those people. Be careful. This is one kind of trick taught by Prabhupada. Prabhupada teaching us. This way we can do your bhajan very safely. So this way actually, now one day actually the king of Madurai, his only daughter, she was caught by a ghost, Brahmadaita. Ghost, oh, that daughter only three, four days due for her marriage. King gone mad. If people going to know my daughter, you know, ghost catching her, who is going to marry? Then crying, oh, you must arrange very secretly. Oh, let Jadavacharya call, is a big Mantacharya. We can call him. Jadavacharya coming. Yes, no, having so mantra and a profound knowledge in mantra. Oh, Acharya, see this condition of my daughter. You must find some solution what to do. Oh, let me do. He is going to put mantra. Ha! A mantra with water and this, that. But the more he is going to try, the more that ghost become very, hey, who are you? I can kill you, foolish. Huh? It's shouting. Huh? Who are you? You're going to? Huh? You previous life was snack. That ghost seeking, previous life, you took the form of a, you know, snack, goshap. When there is full of water, like crocodile, once up. Actually, takhak also, takhak, this special snack, also having the shape of crocodile. But another snack, I myself seen, in 2000 flood, I was in Chaitanya was speaking Harikatha, that time is show. I was in boat, coming to attend the function of Guru Maharaj speaking Harikatha. Yes, so. Like crocodile, small, like lizard, you know. It's called goshap. It's not so harmful, but still. That ghost speaking, you, previous life, what was your form? Goshap, snack. You got the privilege to take the prasadam, uchishta of a pure Vaishnava, somehow. You going here and there, touch the plate of one Vaishnava, leap, and due to that, the magic spell of that Mahaprasadam, now you are going to take the form of Brahman. Who are you? Your student, Lakshman Dasip, going to give me water wash? Then I can go. Who are you? I can kill you. Then you are feeling disturbed, but I am Acharya, that ghost, you know, insulting me. Then Lakshman Dasip was called. Lakshman Desik was bound to give the lotus, because king requesting, na, give the water was of his lotus feet to ghost, and the ghost very happily going to leave this world, you know. Okay, very nice. Then also Jadavacharya was feeling disturbed. I am Acharya. This way every time I am insulted in front of this small boy. Oh my God. We are putting, giving some, having some envious attitude. So he took decision to kill this way. But anyway, when he is going to watch Lakshman Dasik in Bharadvaj, oh, you here? We are crying, searching you whole road. Acting. This way, you must come, your course is not yet complete. You must come and take lesson. Yeah, well, miss, of course I can go. Then after that, he is requesting Kanchipuram, you must give initiation to me, without which I am going to die. Actually, I am fallen soul. I am from a very low caste. I cannot give. No, you must give. Without, you know, I love you very much. I respect you. You must give. Actually, your Gurudev, I am not going to give. Then whom I can accept as Guru? Ah, okay, I can ask to Bharat Raj. I can ask to Bharat Raj Bhagavan, and then I can inform you, after some day. Okay. Then he is going to pray, oh Bharat Raj. They are small and very nice, you know. You know, this Lakshman Desi going to take Diksha from me. I am not fit. So, could you please tell from whom? Then Bharat Raj giving information to Kanchipurna. Then one day, now you took decision, you asked your Bharat. Yes, I took. Mahapurna is your guru. Mahapurna? Where Mahapurna? In Kanchipuram. I must go now? Yes, you can go. Then they are going to meet Mahapurna and, you know, throw himself onto the lotus feet of Mahapurna. Please save me. I like to take, you know, Diksha from you. In the meantime, Lakshman was so powerful, the, you know, the name and fame of Lakshman Desik like flower. Flower is there in garden, automatic good smell. So actually, Jamunacharya got the information. Jamunacharya is Siddha Mahatma. Jamunacharya thought, he is the right personality who can take my lineage. Oh, it's nice. So how to bring in my, how to bring him? Then one day he is going to give Stotraratna, one very sloka book written by Jamunacharya, and giving to one disciple go. And recite. When Lakshman Desi coming to take the son of Bharadvaraj, he go on reciting this stotra very soundly. Then he went on. He going to take the son of Bharadvaraj. Fine. Who reciting this sloka? So nice, sweet. Oh, pay dandavat to him. Who write this? It's Jamunacharya the great. Oh, really? I like to take darshan of Jamunacharya. Well, I can go with me. Then when they are proceeding, but in the meantime, in the midway, got information that Jamunacharya is going to leave body. Jamunacharya is no more. Oh my God, we are going to miss the darshan of Jamunacharya the great. They are crying and crying, and at least they are moving fast so that those karmakandi people cannot get control over the body. Oh, we must go fast. They are running fast and fast. They are reaching the place of Jamunacharya. They find three fingers folded. Fingers. Then everybody is stunned. How? The Jamunacharya, out of his own profound knowledge, Dibya Gyan, he could realize three of his unfulfilled desires are there. First, when Lakshman Desi took decision, I can collect all scriptural evidence from different shastra, and I can arrange so that those common people can come and Drobir Amnai. I can pull them in the track, you know, fresh, so that they can find the clue of Supreme Lord. Follow, I promise. Then one finger open. Second, surely I am going to arrange one Vasya of Vedanta as per the desire of Supreme Lord Bharadvaraj. Then the second finger open. Third, when he took decision, I can make one Gauri, one Abhidan, like our Haridas Baba writing a Gauriya Vaishnava Abhidan, you know. Like, he took decision, he is declaring, I, Parasar Rishi, he is writing so many things, Puran, everything. I can collect from there all vital points, and I can organize all common people to follow the exact track. So I can compile one dictionary, Abhidan. Then the third finger open. Everybody shouting, "Oh, Bharadvaraj ki jai ho!" How possible that, you know? Then everybody could realize he is not ordinary man. He is not ordinary man, he is so powerful in future. I mean, the desire of Jamunacharya is that Lakshman Desik ultimately can follow my track and exhibit his most powerful feature as a great Acharya in South India, in whole world. Then Lakshman Desik took vow to compile all these four jobs unfulfilled in the life of Jamunacharya. Then one by one, he is going to take preparation in this regard. Then in the meantime, Mahapurna is Gurudev, na? And he is going to live in the same village, same place, and the same, because that time there is no hand pump, most of a well, you know, kua. Well, you know, water they are getting. and now you are going to get set pump and, you know, submersal pump, everything you have facility. But that time also, when I was in Vrindavan, there was a common, you know, Suryagunda, big well. Every day we'll have to go collect water from there and arrange for seva, Suryanarayan seva. No other way, drinking water, everything from there, you will have to collect. No other source. And after that, you see, one day, the wife of, you know, Lakshman Desik, going to take water from that well, going to take water through rope and one special pot, everybody's, and the Guru Patni, and the wife of, wife of Gurudev, also going to take water from that. But somehow, due to some disbalance, some water from the pot of Guru Patni, the wife of, some, then from that pot, the some water going to touch the pot of the wife of Lakshman Desh. He become very angry. How you do? You foolish. You are from a low caste. You should be ashamed of this thing. Why you are doing? All useless. I cannot take water. Speaking heavily against Guru Patni. Guru Patni not giving any answer, silently coming at home, giving this information to Guru, I mean husband. Mahapurna, this is the case. Mahapurna said, okay, Lakshman is my heart. So let us go. Let us go away from this place to stop this kind of nonsense. Further, this kind of thing can happen in future, near future also. So better we can go away from there. Then he took decision that day to go with all his luggage, going to leave, going away. When Lakshman Desik took information, where Gurudev? Gurudev suddenly gone. Suddenly gone? What can be the reason? Nobody can say. I meet Gurudev just yesterday also. How Gurudev took decision to go away, but now they are not. Now they are not going to leave. Why? What can be the reason? Then ultimately he took information. Oh my God! This is the case. That's why my Gurudev gone from this place. Well, I am also going to leave my Karmakandi wife forever. Foolish number one. He took decision that day. Somehow I am going to leave this wife. Then one day, one beggar, Brahman beggar, coming. I am very hungry. Can you give some bread and something to me? Hey, go away! Foolish. You cannot do any work. You are begging. Drive him away. That Brahman crying. Then Ramanuja, Lakshman Desik was there someplace. Hey, what happened? You are crying? Actually, I went to this house. Oh, you went to my wife? Yes. What's he speaking? Not giving any prasadam, nothing. Bhiksha. Oh, speaking rubbish against me, heavy. Wait. I can find out one clue. Come on. You will have to go there. No, I cannot go. Oh, hear me. She can give you all prasadam, very nice. One formula I can speak you. What formula? Actually, you will have to take this card, a marriage, handwritten. There was not press that time, handwritten. Written that your brother, arrangement of your mother, marriage of your brother, arrangement going on, she will have to come. With one turmeric, is auspicious. Mother used to give turmeric and oil at the time of Saraswati Puja, daily. Morning time giving turmeric, everything and giving. Water and what is the roots? So I can remember. Turmeric actually, putting turmeric, print and giving. Now you go. I am coming from your father's house. Really? Then she can give all prasadam, full. Up to this point, she can give you. Oh, then he is again going to home. Mother, again you come? Actually, I forget to give you this invitation letter. What invitation? Oh, my brother's marriage, yes. Your brother's marriage, that's why I forget to give you actually. You come. come and sit. And after that, full prasadam up to this point. Giving prasadam, after prasadam is dvaya, pranami, everything. You are going, na? Yes, I must go. Today I can start. Yeah, okay, you can go. Then the Brahmin go away from this place. Ramanujacharya coming back. What happens? What preparation? Actually, my brother's man. Oh, really? Very nice. So you must go. I'm going. But this time, actually, your brother's marriage, you must carry all your ornament and, you know, nice clothes. Actually, it's very important because all relatives coming, they have some, you know, position and rank. Oh, sure you are. Your advice is very good. I must carry all my ornaments and clothes. But Ramanujacharya, foolish number one. Then he packed all his ornaments and clothes, everything, and starting for the house. Ah, that's father's house. Gone. Ramanujacharya taking bath, going in front of Bharatacharya, taking the ears. So, Prabhu, from today onward, I am only your. From today, only and only I am your. Ah, all problem gone. Then he took decision to take sannyas at the bank of Ananta Sarovar. He took decision, remembering Jamunacharya, from the portrait of Jamunacharya, took Tidanda sannyas. His portrait of Jamunacharya, he took sannyas from Jamunacharya. This is the same thing done by Prabhupada. Nobody knows. They are going to criticize idiot number one. They don't know the heart of those Mahajan, great, you know, Acharya. Then after that, taking sannyas at the bank of Ananta Sarovar, he took resolution to start his own mission for the emancipation of those fallen souls. He started his mission. After taking sannyas one by one, so many people coming and taking diksha. First, his name was, by the desire of Bharat Raj, his name was Ramanujacharya. Lakshman and Ramanujacharya all same. Lakshman means Ramanujacharya. Ram Anuja iti Ramanuja. Ram Anuja means younger brother of Ram is Ramanuja. So, same name, Ramanujacharya. He now, his mission started. He started giving initiation to different, those who are willing to lead a nice devotional life. Like Govinda also came, he gave, and Kuresh also. Everybody came. Not only that, the mother of Jadavacharya. Jadavacharya is Mayavadi. Jadavacharya, I already told, Jadavacharya, as the Vedanta teacher, is all Mayavadi, foolish. But his mother is, you know, fine devotion. Mother speaking, "Oh my son, you have done great mistake. You have done apradh unto the lotus feet of Lakshman Desik. You must go and take initiation from me. Initiation from him." What do you say? Yes. You have committed a great mistake, apradh. If you are not going to beg for pardon, then you can die. Be careful, go. Then, by the desire of Bharat Raj, in the meantime, he also started calculating that my way is not good. Follow. Not only that, the mother going to put pressure. Not only this, not the only reason that mother going to put pressure on son. The son, I mean, Jadavacharya also started, you know, calculating, maybe my track is not good. Oh, so good reputation all around. So what's wrong in it? I can go and beg for pardon. Then Jadavacharya also coming and taking shelter onto the lotus feet of Ramanujacharya. Ramanujacharya also bless him and giving diksha. After that, giving sannyas also. Follow? This way. This way actually is going to initiate Kuresh, everybody. In the meantime, he got information from Shailapurno and Kanchipurno, and also from this Gurudev Mahapurno. That in there all my god brother, but my son, be careful. There is one Goshtipurno. He is knowing all the mystery of mantra. Jamunacharya directly giving this treasure with him. Oh, really? I must go and take it. Okay, you can go and try. Jamunacharya putting this treasure, Mantracharya, all the secrecy of mantra. Oh, everything knowing. Saharasa mantra, if you like to get the mystery of mantra, or giving by Jadavacharya, Jamunacharya, you must go and collect it. You must go. I give you permission. Then he is going to meet and praying, and very cravingly, please, please give me, without the mystery of mantra, how I can do bhajan, how I can do my seva properly, how I can fulfill the desire of Jamunacharya, please, please. But one condition, you cannot speak this mantra to anybody. This condition I put. Then, come on. Then, very solitary room, he's going to speak all the mystery of mantra related, mantra word and mantra, you know, all secrecy speaking, and the mantra itself. Don't try to speak it to anybody. It is my strict order to you. Then, Ramanujaja coming back, giving this mantra to 74 different disciples, loudly, same mantra. Violating the instruction of mantravid Goshtipurna, giving this mantra. Goshtipurna when came to know, oh, you violate my instruction, you are going to hell, be careful. Before giving this mantra, Rahasas, I already put condition before you, you are going to violate me, you are going to hell. Ramanujaja with folded hand, oh Gurudev, countless jivatma there, they are feeling pain. If they are going to get some benefit, I am useless, selfish. If I am going to hell, what wrong in it? Then goes to Purnavala, oh, so great heart. All those common people, they are suffering, you see, for them. If I going to do something concrete for them, so the mantra I was bound to give to them, if I am going to hell, no problem. I am a fallen soul. What value I have? Let them go. By the power of this mantra, they can come out and go to exact place. Then Goshtipurna understand, he is not a matter of joke. He is not, you know, selfish at all. It's great Vaishnava. So by that time, the mood of excusing coming inside. Okay, no problem. Then after that, by the blessings of Goshtipurna, Mahapurna, Shailapurna, Kanchipurna, they are speaking. Ramanuja took decision, now started his vision, how to fulfill, because it is my commitment. I took resolution to fulfill the desire of Jamunacharya, so I must try first. He started his own seva. Life is more uncertain now. We must do Guru Seva right now. No delay. Then he started going to this one place there, ashram there, Nishinga ashram there in Kashmir place. There. Actually, from there he, crying how to arrange. He took information one Bodhayan Basa, one Bodhayan tips, very nice, formula written by Bodhayanji in the same parampara. If I can collect it, is very easy for me to write Srivasya, very easy. So I must collect it. But it is there in certain place, there in hilly place, Sharada Ashram. Ashram is Mayavadi Ashram. controlled by all the Shankaracharya, you know, members. They are, you know, they are from their parampara. They go straightway and pray to them. We heard that Buddha and Vasa is there, kept with you. Please, would you, please give? No, nothing there. Who told you? Who told you? No Buddha and Vasa there. Oh, really? But we heard Buddha and Vasa is there, kept secretly. No Buddha and Vasa there. You can go away. Okay, night time I can take, morning time I can. Night time he is crying in front of Nrisimhadev, oh Prabhu. I wanted to do this seva, you are not going to help me. Nrisimhadev laughing, getting getting that Bodhanvasa from inside Almira. What not possible for Supreme Lord? Getting and handing, handing over to you, take it, now fly, very quickly. Nrisimhadev himself giving. Kortum akartum annathakartum ya samarthaha saiswaraha. Giving this then. Now fly from here very quickly. They fly around very quickly here. After 1 month, they discover that place is vacant. Oh, that, you know, Ramanujaja must have stolen. Oh, they arrange, oh, very, very powerful man. 10 or 12, go fast, run, and catch them in the midway. Otherwise, if it is missing, all our parampara, Mayavadi parampara, can break down. Go quickly, fast. They are running day and night, day and night, day and night. Then after 1 month, almost 1 month over, they are going to catch him and fight. Ramanujaja is so powerful, Ramanujaja himself can beat them and kill them. But Ramanujaja is not going to manifest this kind of leela. They snatch away. They take away forcefully the Bodhi and Vasa from him and gone. Ramanujaja now praying, oh Prabhu, I got the chance, but I missed the chance. What to do now? Kure speaking, Gurudev, don't think. Why? That Vasa is missing. Missing, okay, let it be. Let them take it. But I memorize. Memorize when? But in the night time when you are sleeping, I used to memorize all. I recite everything. Recite everything? I can write very quickly. Within 4 or 5 days I can write. Then started writing all Vadan Vasa. No grammatical mistake, no punctuation mistake, nothing. Oh, the Toto. Ramanujaji was very happy, blessing this disciple. To see the power, memory, oh, by Guru Seva. By Guru Seva, by Guru Seva, by Guru Vishnu Seva. One can develop that kind of power. How you know? What is Seva? Who knows? If I can fulfill the desire of Prabhupada, if I can fulfill the desire of Bhakti Mahatpur Gishri Maharaj, if I can fulfill the desire of Siddha Maharaj, if I can fulfill the desire of Keshav Goswami Maharaj, why not power coming to me? If at all there is honest desire, if at all there is honest desire inside my heart, is there any lackage of power there with them? Is there any lackage? Lack of power? No, they are going to give power to me. But the main problem is that I am kapat. I am kapat, that's the main problem. Kures now helping the Ramanujaja. Okay, I am going to speak the Srivasa. I can accept you as my writer, like Vyasadeva when writing accept Ganesh ji Maharaj as his writer. Vyasadeva Goswami Maharaj speaking and Vyasadeva Goswami writing. Vyasadeva Goswami speaking, you will have to write, but very carefully, without understanding, realizing. Ganesh said, well, also, it is my condition, if you stop speaking, I can stop my writing, I cannot write more. Then Vyasa speaking, well, I have also condition that if you write, you will have to write with full knowledge. Without realization, you cannot write. Then Vyasa Maharaj speaking, in between he is making some intricacy, you know, intricacy, complicacy in the sloka. So Ganesh Ji Maharaj, what can be the meaning? Thinking. In the meantime, Vyasa Goswami also calculating and seeking. So intricacy there. Vyasa Goswami purposely making. It is Kut Slok. It's called Kuta Slok. In Mahabharata also, here, there, oh, everywhere. Some Kut Slok. Kut mane, you cannot understand. What can be the meaning? You cannot make any head or tail. Ganesh Ji Maharaj is very powerful. Vidwan is going to write. This way. So now, Ramanujacharya is going to accept whom? Accept Kuresh. I like to accept you as my writer. I think going on, Srivasa complete. This way, one by one, going to complete. One by one. In between, Krimikanta, the king. One king there in south. He is a Saiva. His Ishtadeva is Shiva. When hearing the name and fame of Ramanujacharya going up and up day by day, he took decision to kill. Oh, you must call him, the king calling. They forcefully gone to catch Ramanujacharya to bring. They are going to arrange one logical interpretation. Follow. One altercation, you know. He can put one Pandit in on his behalf, going to establish or receive his men on his behalf, this party. Ramanujacharya should speak. If they are deviated, they will have to accept Shiva. Then what problem? They all come in group. They never seen Ramanujacharya. Then Kure speaking, Gurudev, you don't go. They coming, I can go. You can go? Yes, I can go. Take the besh of Gurudev, going in front of, what do you want? What is your name? My name is Ramanujacharya. Oh, you have to come. Krimikanta, the king, calling you. You have to go. Then they catch him, Kuresh, and bring into this Shava assembly. They are all big, you know, Saiva. There is big fighting going on. Kuresh is going to give answer very sweetly, politely. Every time they are putting argument, Kuresh is going to break Siddhanta and want to establish that Vishnu is all, above all. They become very angry. Hey, you will have to accept our sampradaya. You will have to accept this mantra from this guru. How I can accept? Because Vishnu is all. I too already took decision. No, we don't like to hear anything. You will have to accept. Then they catch him and bring. And after that, when he is not ready to accept, they eradicate the two eyes, eyeball. Eradicate. Then all blood coming, he is speaking, Gurudev, Gurudev. In blind condition, they throw him out. After that, Ramanujacharya thinking from there. Ramanujacharya is not ordinary. So Kuresh, the disciple, crying and coming in front of Gurudev with his blind eyes. What happens? This happens. Then Ramanujacharya is going to pray in front of Bharadwaj. It is for your cause. He is going to give his own two eyes. You will have to give Prabhu. You will have to arrange. Then Kuresh developing one very nice eyes. Dibba Chakshu, through which you can see past, present, and future, everything more better than previous. Getting this way. This way, Ramanujacharya go on breaking all Mayavad Siddhanta, all smashed. I think Parapakha Giribarjo, Bajro, also written by Ramanujacharya. One big books. If Mayavad is going to read it, their head can crust, get down. Parapakha Giribarjo, Thunderbolt. It means thunderbolt. For Mayavad Siddhanta, Parapakha Giribajro, book. Now it's rare book. Very nice. Then after that, you see, started his mission and went on doing. Ramanujacharya making disciple one by one, big. All different important people coming to take diksha from Ramanujacharya, the great. One by one, all disciples. They are, Ramanujacharya giving one by one their respective seva. They are doing seva. Follow. So many cases, I cannot finish. So, you know, big thing. I will have to speak about Ramanujacharya for a long time, but one of his disciples, Bharadraj. Disciple, Bharadraj. They are very poor, very, very poor. In one full piece of cloth is not there in the body of wife. So beautiful wife, but no cloth. All torn. What to do? One day, Ramanujacharya with full troops went there to their house to take, to give kippa, to accept seva. But wife cannot come out and husband is not him. Because one, only one torn cloth given in sunlight to drying, after that she can wear. In the meantime, wife doing this indication. Ramanujacharya could realize some problem. Then somehow you arrange one cloth, throw inside room, with this cloth coming out, pay dandavad, Gurudev, we are so crying and crying, with blasted into tears. I couldn't come, I know the situation. No, actually we are lucky that you are coming here to take seva. You take rest, I am arranging everything. Then that wife going to a big businessman with rice, chawl, rice, wheat, all ghee, oil, sabji, everything there, going to bake. But that businessman was very wicked. He is giving indication, you have money? No. Okay, no money, you will have to come to me night time. Well, I can come? Yes, I can come, I promise you. But you will have to give. Then take. All giving to him is coming and making big feast, Bandara. Mahaprasad. Gurudev taking Mahaprasad. After that, in the meantime, husband, brother also coming. He is appreciating wife. Really, you are my wife. For the seva of Gurudev, you are giving to, you are going to give your life. So you are my wife. We are enjoying full kippa of my Gurudev. Be sure. Then after that, prasadam, big bandara was there. Gurudev Ramanuja also taking prasadam. After that, a foot remains. The residue of Ramanujacharya was kept secretly. And wife believed, maha, maha prasadam, magic spell there. Like Mahaprabhu shouting in front of Sarvabhauma, today I conquer the whole world because you now develop the belief, strong belief in Mahaprasadam. What more I want? So, now what happens? That wife in the night time going to that businessman, well, you come. Yes, I promise you to come. But it is my request, my Gurudev came. So, first of all, you will have to take prasadam first. Okay, why not? Give prasadam. Then after that, I'm here, I'm not going. First you take prasadam. Then he took prasadam. First prasadam, when touching tongue, he changes mood. Magic spell. What is the magic spell of maha maha prasadam? Now you see, readily change. And coming to beg pardon and to her lotus feet, you are great. You excuse me. I need nothing. Change mood. By the desire of Ramanujacharya, she coming back untouched. The glories of Gurudev, they are shouting. This is called Guru. This way Ramanujacharya, one by day, one by one, going to give huge kippa to different people. One nice incident I can speak. Very nice. One of his, disciple, his name was Dhanurdas. His name was Dhanurdas. He's very rich people, having so many ornaments, everything. His wife is very, very beautiful. And all the time, Dhanurdas putting wife in front and watching the beauty of wife. all the time. All the time. Even when going somewhere with umbrella, then umbrella is setting umbrella and wife putting his backside going with umbrella, watching the face of wife. So everybody going to complain with Ramanujacharya. What is this Gurudev? What happens? Dhanudas idiot this way, going to, you know. This is the condition of Dhanudas Gurudev. Please you see, we are not going to show our face in front of public this way. This is the condition. Fallen stage. Okay, okay, I can see. He called Dhanudas. Dhanudas, what happened? Because actually I cannot... And I have strong love for my wife. She is so beautiful. What to do? Okay, you can come with me to Bharadvaja's temple. When? Morning time you can go. Only you can go with me. Eh? Okay? In front of Bharadvaja, he is taking, hey, come with me. And going. In front of Bharadvaja, Ramanuja paying dandavat, prostrate and praying, oh Bharadvaja, oh Prabhu. You are so beautiful, you are so... Why is foolish going to be attracted by wife's beauty? It is your responsibility, Prabhu. Show your glamour, show your appearance, so that he is going to cut her maya. Is maya. Maya, always maya. Follow. Then... By the request of Ramanujacharya, Bharadvaja going to show his own feature. Dhanurjaya looking, what is this? Oof! I cannot expect in this material planet this kind of, you know, appearance. Then, from then onward, he forget the beauty of wife. He started worshipping Bharadvaja from heart of Prabhu. Oh Prabhu! From today onward, I am going to show my devotion unto his lotus feet. So many cases I don't like to enlarge because so many things, but I have no time actually. Now, actually, this way, Ramanujacharya one by one going to preach extensively. Mayavad almost going to be finished. But still today again, Mayavad, Prabhupada speaking. Today also we need fresh preaching. Follow? First preaching you have to do. But everybody interested to go to foreign country. Nobody going here and there, you know, they are going to foreign. They are less interested about. You have to go. So this way, what is the... Today I can speak the main Siddhanta of... Today I can speak the main Siddhanta of Ramanujacharya in gist. Tomorrow if time... Permit, I can discuss some comparative statement. Actually, Ramanujacharya speaking actually is main thing, main, three vital things. Ramanujacharya speaking that with full Sambandha Gyan, with full Sambandha Gyan, you will have to worship and meditate Supreme Lord. Sambandha Gyan, when you develop relationship with Sambandha Gyan, without that, you cannot start avidya. And the ultimate prayajan is the lotus feet of Narayan. Naturally, yesterday I also told, when Ishtadev is Narayan, so naturally he is going to pass. Not that Ramanujacharya have no idea about that Krishna is the topmost. If you speak this way, is wrong. Ramanujacharya can know everything. This is a Siddhanta. But anyway, everybody like to establish Ishtadev topmost. Tulsidev is going to establish Ramchandra top this way. Jiva Goswami Pai again going to break this Siddhanta and establish that Krishna is all in all. Ishwaraha Paramakrishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadi Radhi Govinda Sarva Karana Karana. This was established. So Govinda is all, but yesterday also I was bound to give this kind of meaning. Maybe Ramanujacharya is very clever. He appeared here in this material planet by the desire of Supreme Lord. He has some specific tasks. Maybe up to that point, he can proceed up to that point. After that, he need not, hey, you will have to go up to that point. After that, some other Mahajan can come and do more by the instruction. So we cannot say Ramanujaya in not knowing anything about this fact that Krishna is all in all. This kind of meaning we also we can make when Brahma speaking with Krishna, Krishna speaking, hey, your father is, you know, Narayan from the Nebal's proud you develop, you know. Why you are going to speak? Oh Prabhu, you are actually original Narayan. He is Narayan. But you are actually original Narayan. So don't try to make fool of me. You are actually original Narayan. This kind of meaning also I can get? This kind of meaning also possible. That Ramanujaya can think that Krishna is topmost, but still, for those who are going to follow him, like to set some yardstick standard. But up to that point, they are not mature to understand all this. And Krishna, Prema, Gopi, all the Madhacharya also, this way, keeping his limbing up to this point, everybody going to criticize. Oh, Madhacharya, not having any idea about any Shuddha, Siddhanta, Shuddha, you know, Gopi, Prema. Who told you? Who told you? They are foolish, knowing everything. So this way actually we will have to understand. I already told that Vishishta Daitavad is Ramanujacharya, has some reason. And Shuddha Daitavad, Ramanujacharya, Shuddha Madhvacharya, Shuddha Daitavad. Vishnu Swami Shuddha Daitavad, Shuddha Daitavad. And Nimbarkacharya Dvaitadvaitavad. And also there is also division. Bhaskaracharya Upadhik Bhedvad. Follow. But we Gauriya, we are going to establish this ultimate Siddhanta, that Achinta Vedavetata. From different sampradaya, Mahaprabhu collect four different things. From Madhvacharya, the strict, you know, the strong Siddhanta of the tremendous love for Vigraha, Sachidananda. That being the root cause of Achinta of this Gauriya Sampradaya, so Mahaprabhu accept this Madhu Sampradaya. From Ramanujacharya, Shakti Siddhanta, from Vishnu Swami, Shuddhadvaita, and from Nimbarkacharya, some Dvaita, Nitya Ved, this all four three different Siddhanta collected by Mahaprabhu wanted to show all those different Siddhanta somehow not complete. Follow what I say. All four different Acharyas going to give four different Siddhantas, but it is itself not complete. So Mahaprabhu, out of his own power, collect all four different things from four different sampradayas, going to give us a nice harmony to prove one point, achinto, only achinto, this word used. And then wanted to prove the achinta Vedavatata, Avatachacharya Baladev Vidyavasan, Avatachacharya, you know, Jiva Goswami, all established this unique tata. Tomorrow I like to discuss some basic points of the four Acharyas, also some special points of our Achinta Vedavatvalta. Please excuse me, time is over. Vancha Kalpataro Sekipa Sindhu Vavacha Pachitanang Pavane Bhavishnabhyo Namo Namo.